Hello everyone, thanks very much for joining us and welcome to our Christmas edition of Take Two. For tonight's episode, we asked our usual presenter, Conor Caldwell, to put together a special Christmas performance for us. So he's joined by his wife, Sarah Caldwell, Jamie Bishop and Ram Malloy, and that's one fantastic performance not to be missed. Also on the show, we have an interview with our very own arts officer, Lizzie Devlin, North Belfast born and bred, a performance from a duo from the Glengormley School of Traditional Music, Alex Walsh and Martin Scott, and finally, a fantastic performance from Fermanagh duo, Laytha. I hope you enjoy tonight's show and thanks again for joining us.
So Ryan and I are going to perform a very well-known Christmas song for you now. It's Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Hi, my name is Alex and this is Martin, and we're going to start off by playing two reels. So the first one is called Boys of Man, and then we're going to play the Gravel Walks after.
Thank you. Hi, we're Laytha, and the song is called Daylight.
I once knew a low late midnight sun, drew the waters close, the sky and it became one. How did the world seem so still but so
on the stage now, Ryan and I are joined by Jamie Bishop and Conor Caldwell. And we are going to perform for you a song from a completely different season. We've went for summertime.
Fish.
This next song is called In This Town.
This is Songs of Love by The Divine Comedy.
Pale pubescent bees roam through the streets and coffee shops. Their prey gather in herds in stiff knee-length skirts and wide ankle socks. And while they search for a mate, my type hibernate in bedrooms above, composing their songs of love. Young uniform minds in uniform lines and uniform ties run round with trousers on fire and signs of desire they can't disguise. While I try to find words as light as the birds that circle above to put in my songs of love. Faith doesn't hang on a wrong other boys. So let's sing while we have time. Let the song shine down from above and fill you with songs of
is called The Wave Game, but we've nicknamed it Wavy Gimme.
Deep and drowning with no hope.
This song is called Sparboy.
With his chin on the counter, in his head, in his hands, a man of seven or thereabouts, he begs me please not to give alcohol to an aunt of his. He picks his nose, he buys a Freddo. And he wanders home as I asphyx a cell of Twix that's set to melt in some arse pocket. Hi, why do we feel the need to whisper sorries down the aisle? She crashes in through the wall and dashes forward, a stash of Pratsky for the chaser Panadol. She loves the crack, her mother's back with her chin in her mouth and a child in her hands. All her fish and her fearmongers laugh. And we lose our grasp as you sphinx in frenzy sink at the implication that you've had too much to drink. We talk in limps, a shopper's glimpse through their prying eyes. We hobble to some compromise, a solar one to my own surprise.
Next set of tunes we're going to be doing is a set of jigs. The first one's called Hag at the Churn, and then the second one's called Garrett Barry's Jig. So, ready? One, two.
Thank you.
so for our final performance together, we are going to perform for you a traditional song called On the Banks of Red Roses.
Song and it's called What Will I Gain?
Don't let the bees face, as she regretted that in her younger days. In my father, I see his trace. Will I forever be in this place?
We're going to play A Pair of Brown Eyes by the Pogues.
One summer's evening, drunk to hell, I sat there nearly lifeless, and an old man in the corner cried, where the water lilies grow. And on the jukebox, Johnny sang about a thing called love. And it's how are you, kid, and what's your name, and how do you bloody know? Need sun and death and a screaming sky, I lay down on the ground, and the arms and legs of other men were scattered all around. Some cursed and prayed, and prayed and cursed and bled some more. And the only thing that I could see was a pair of brown eyes waiting for me. When we got back, labor parts 1, 2, 3, there was no pair of brown eyes waiting for me. And a rove and a rove and a rove and a rove for a pair of brown eyes. so drunk to hell. I left the place sometimes walking, sometimes crawling. And a hungry sign came across the breeze, so I gave the walls a talking. I heard the sound of long ago from the old canal, and the birds were whistling in the trees, and the wind was gently laughing, and a road and a road and a road and a road and a road.
August Ryan, I got a couple of reel ahen you minish. We're going to play a couple of reels. When traditional musicians are asked to play a tune at Christmas, we always go for this tune, Christmas Eve, even though it's kind of nothing really to do with Christmas except the title. So anyway, we'll give that a bash. We'll follow that up with the Abbey reel, and then we're going to finish off with a tune that I learned from Paul O'Shaughnessy. It's called Patsy Hanley's. So my students with the Glengormley School of Traditional Music have been learning a couple of these tunes this year. So if you have your instruments close by, you can join in with us anyway. So here we go.
Thank you.
Right. This song is called Chum.
Dear old friend, do your dishes. I'm tired of waking up in your messes. Dear old pal, clean your pubes from the shower to dear chum. I was wrong. About you, they were high. Mine too.
Last set of tunes we're going to be doing is a set of reels. The first one is called Dinkies. The second one is called The Road to Ballymac, and the third one is called The Silver Spear.
Hi, Lizzie. Welcome to the Duncairn. Thanks very much for taking the time to come down tonight. It's absolutely freezing in the centre tonight because the heating's not working. So I'll just introduce you to everybody, Lizzie. Development Officer at the Arts Council of Northern Ireland, currently responsible for community arts.
Yes, well, my role, Debbie, at the Arts Council is arts development. And so really I would be supporting the community arts sector. And that's very broad. That would be everything from arts organisations that engage with communities and very diverse communities to individual artists and helping them support and develop their work in socially engaged practice in all its forms. It would include intercultural organisations. It would include socially engaged theatre companies. So a very broad portfolio, and again, my role is to support the sector along with my colleagues. Yeah.
It's not the only hat you wear though, because in your other life you have and I don't want to say secondary role, because it's probably a big priority in your life, the art therapy.
Yeah. So yes, my principal job is the Arts Council, and that dominates most of my week. I guess my background's in fine art, and I worked in venues in Belfast and community arts and education. And that kind of really drew me into training as an art psychotherapist. Mm-hmm. So I do that a couple of days a week. And that's really working in a mental health capacity, working in mental health in various organisations with children and adults.
Creativity kind of flows through everything that you do, nine to five, Monday to Friday,
it does,
really.
Yes, in different ways, in different forms, yes.
And you've been really challenged at the Arts Council recently, even, you know, transferring that work space to home.
Yes.
Must be difficult or different, at least.
Yes, I think for us all at this time, it's been a time of very high anxiety about the health of our family, about the health of our community. And I think at the start of COVID, we were all watching far too much news and looking at our phones far too much. And I think for me, for everybody, it's about trying to have that balance of sort of work and also using creative methods for relaxation to sustain our well-being.
Yeah.
I suppose we've all had grown an appreciation of the important things as well. Yeah. We've had to draw back from, some of us have drawn back from social media. We're, you know, more, I suppose, confined in terms of, you know, where we're walking around and what we're seeing. And I have to say that, you know, I live in North Belfast, mm-hmm. and I have always loved living in North Belfast, but particularly at this time, I've had a real enhanced appreciation for where I live.
Yeah.
In terms of its environment, in terms of Cave Hill and places I can walk around, but also for the people. They've really shown in terms of showing how much they care and support mm-hmm. each other. And I think that's broadly right across Belfast and Northern Ireland. It's brought out the best in people. Yeah.
So right now, Lizzie, you know, with the pandemic and with your, you know, the mental health hat on, there's been a real drive, I think, in the arts recently as a tool to help improve and sustain people's mental health?
Well, I think there's been more of a public recognition.
Aye.
I think in Northern Ireland, we have a legacy here because of the conflict of, you know, very high rates of poor mental health and intergenerational trauma and everything that's happened. I know in the Arts Council, we've recognised the value of the arts in supporting individuals' mental health. And we do that across a broad spectrum of our portfolios, of our programmes. So we have a young people and mental health programme, and we have an arts and older people's programme. So, and they would have very specific aims about addressing individuals with mental health challenges, and older people experience isolation. So we know even pre-COVID that as a society in Northern Ireland, we've had those difficulties. It certainly brought it more into the public arena in terms of what the arts can do for our health and well-being, in terms of sustaining us and supporting us, connecting us. That connectivity is so important mm-hmm. in terms of building people's individual resilience, community resilience, and just helping people cope with life challenges or things that have happened in the past or their experience in the present. So
let's kind of broaden the idea of creativity too, you know.
Yes, I think when people think about art or the arts, they think about it in a way that doesn't feel accessible to many people. You know, it's kind of something that's out of reach and over there. But actually, you know, creativity and creative community is something that's a lived experience, I think.
Uh-huh.
It's something that we can all build into our day. You know, it's everything from, as you said, creative journaling, to baking, to listening to music, to gardening. We have a great legacy here of the textile industry,
mm-hmm.
and there's a huge amount of talent there. We have also our culture of metalwork and rope works. So, and that comes down the generations in terms of what people are interested in.
Yeah, it's
so
lovely to see it.
It's very
on,
broad,
isn't it?
Yeah.
And what's your favourite creative outlet then, Lizzie? What's the thing that would take you into the zone?
Well, my background is fine arts, so it's visual arts. Really, what takes me into the zone is there's no perfect environment. I don't have a home studio. I just take some moments during the day. I would do creative journaling. I would just use whatever's to hand. Nothing that would be, you know, sometimes it's just intuitive, it's just mark making. Sometimes I set myself a goal of doing a few quick sketches every day. And it doesn't have to be a perfect environment for me. It's just taking a few moments, whatever is to hand, allowing myself that time, 10 minutes, half an hour, before I go back to whatever he needs attended to in the day.
It is about making that space, isn't it? Because I think even pre-COVID, we were all living in a bit of a... You felt guilty if you took any time out to make room for that creativity.
Yes.
It doesn't feel so difficult now to take the space.
Yeah.
It's a necessity, I think, for a lot of people.
And developing a creative space is, you know... It's something that the Duncairn has done here. The Duncairn has established a shared space, a safe space, and a very creative space that's very welcoming to all communities in North Belfast. And there is no perfect environment for making art. You know, it's just about having whatever you need to hand, having a good enough environment and having good enough materials and not being judgmental about yourself.
Yeah. Well, look, thanks very much for coming, Lizzie. It's been a real joy talking to you. It's lovely to see you again. And hopefully we'll be back at live events sooner rather than later.
Yeah, thank you. It's been an absolute pleasure to be back in the Duncairn after so many months. And I really hope that we can all meet together in the new year safely and just start to appreciate the real talent and creativity of what happens here and also the creative talent of artists living in North Belfast. And the community so appreciate this venue. It is like a light, it's like a beacon in the cultural map of North Belfast. In terms of what it's doing, it's truly incredible.
Thank you for that, Lizzie. Have a great week.
Okay, thank you.
I hope you enjoyed tonight's show and thanks very much once more for joining us. On behalf of everybody here at the Duncairn and the Take Two team, we hope you have a wonderful, a very happy and a very safe Christmas. Nollaconadh.